Bunker is usually constructed deep in the earth. It is recommended that the bunker be constructed at least 6 feet underground to protect against lethal radiation. In this video, we'll construct the bunker at a depth of 10 feet, with a clear height of 8 feet, so our final depth will be 20 feet. At some point during the excavation of soil, groundwater may be discovered if the water table at the construction site is high. This water must be pumped out using a sump pump to continue construction. The water should be lowered at least 1 meter below the construction level. As we keep digging, there may be a danger of the surrounding soil collapsing, which would affect the construction process. To avoid soil collapse, we'll employ a technique known as shoring. Shoring will provide temporary lateral support to the surrounding soil. Once we have reached our desired level, it's time to thoroughly compact the soil. Before proceeding further, make a bore to extract water from a deep underground source for future use. After the compaction process, treat the soil for termites and then cover the site with a polythene sheet. The next step is to cast lean concrete, which would provide a uniform base for the foundation steel. We'll apply a PVC waterproofing membrane to the lean concrete. Then cover that membrane with Secrete to protect it from being damaged by the rebars. Next, it's time to fix the steel for a raft foundation, but before that we'll place spacers between steel and Secrete. For the bunker walls, we will construct reinforced concrete retaining walls. We will repeat the same process of lean PVC membrane and protection Secrete for tunnel foundation. Now it's time to fix the steel for tunnel. We cannot use a straight vertical manhole for the entrance to the bunker because it would expose the bunker to radiation. To avoid this, we need to construct a long tunnel at right angles with multiple airtight doors. Now it's time to erect the formwork to pour concrete for the bunker base, bunker walls, and tunnel walls. In one of the retaining walls, we'll need 4 holes. It's time to erect slab formwork and construct bunker slab. The slab must be designed to carry the load of the backfill. Since the length and width of the bunker are 14 feet and 12 feet, the slab will be designed as a two-way slab. After fixing the steel, it's time to pour the concrete for the slab. We'll install 3 airtight steel doors inside our entrance tunnel to avoid contamination. Next, we'll fix the steel for the tunnel slab, which will be designed as a one-way slab. Steel fixing is followed by pouring concrete for the tunnel slab. Since our bunker is going to be buried, we'll have to apply external PVC membrane and protection board to our structure, just like this. A bunker is ready. Now it's time to make arrangements for oxygen and other needs. It is recommended to use a composting toilet as it has to be emptied after 60 days or even more depending on the type of the toilet. Install a hand pump to extract groundwater for non-potable uses. Install a nuclear biological chemical filter for contamination-free air. The NBC filter can be powered by a 12-volt battery and also be operated manually by a hand crank in case of a power outage. Now it's time to bury the bunker with loose soil. Out of the four holes that we had in our wall, the tiny hole will be used to exhaust stale air out of the bunker. Second hole will be used to bring in outside air for the filtration unit. The third hole will be used to bring in the wires from solar panels and windmill. Make sure it's airtight. And the fourth hole will be used to pump out wastewater out of the bunker. The pipe that takes in the air into the bunker should be away from the pipe that would take the stale air out of the bunker. For additional protection, the inside of the tunnel and doors should have lead drywalls. Make sure that the bunker has enough potable water and canned food for all the occupiers for at least 6 months. Replace the provisions after every 6 months to keep them fresh. Also make sure that all the appliances inside the bunker, such as fans and bulbs, are 12 volt. If you are planning to keep an electricity generator in the bunker, then use a propane generator instead of a diesel generator because propane has a longer shelf life as compared to diesel. Other things that might come in handy are a radio, first aid kit, PPE for radiation and radiation detectors. Is there anything else that you would like to add to the bunker or the overall construction process? Let me know in the comments.